Storm Watch here with your early morning weather forecast. As you can see on the map behind me, we have been hit overnight by a nor'easter that pounded our community with buckets and buckets of fluffy white precipitation. If you don't believe me, just look out the window. There's snow on the lake. There's snow on the trees. There's snow on the streets. Folks, there's snow everywhere. Ladies and gentlemen, it's fantastic. For all we know, anything can happen when it snows. On a sad note, because of this blizzard, school will have to be called off for the rest of the week.
Snowman. It's the fabulous and hilarious Zamboni sisters.
What do you get if you cross a snowman and a mean dog?
I don't know. What do you get if you cross a snowman and a mean dog?
Frostbite! I've got one. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Freeze.
Freeze who?
Freeze a German LaFelle. He's a jolly good fellow.
What do snowmen wear on their heads?
Ice caps.
What do snowmen eat for lunch?
Ice burgers.
Where do snowmen go to dance?
Snowballs.
How do snowmen travel around?
By icicles!
It's a little crazy when the snow starts to fall.
Bye.
Anyways, these are my assistants, Professor Snow and Professor Flake.
No, I'm Professor Snow and she's Professor Flake. You could just breathe and make hats.
Remember?
Anyway, I'm 17-year-old Wondering, what does that make us Snow? About what?
What makes us Snow?
I have no idea. Yes, Key, yes, Key. Now you should be very careful. A snowflake starts out with three ingredients: water vapor, ice crystals, and dust.
Dust!
Wait, where's my dust? As I was saying, dust. Around the dust, a super cold cloud has brought us super cold water droplets and the ice crystals. When the water droplets and ice crystals collide with a cloud, the droplet freezes to it. This makes it grow into a larger ice crystal. When many ice crystals grow, they stick together and suddenly fall. This is what we call a snowflake.
Thank you.
sweaters. We're gonna pound some pow today.
What? He means hello, snowbird enthusiast. There's fresh snow on the mountain, perfect for snowboarding.
What language is he speaking?
Oh, it's snowboarder lingo. I'm fluent. Watch this. Yo, dude, you're gonna slay the trail before you fail?
We have two plinkets. My posse and I built a slick kicker in the backcountry, and we aim to gap the pike with my plank tonight. But with dust on the crust, that fat nine should be swank.
He means hello, skiers. My friends and I have taken the opportunity to pile up a lot of snow in order to build a snow ramp off the regular ski trail.
You're going to try some jumps in our snowboards later on this evening.
He also indicated that they are going to carefully check out the landing before they try anything new. But with the fresh new fallen snow on top of the hard pack underneath, the jump that they have prepared should be really, swank.
Cool. And why did he just say so?
Hey!
Excuse me, fisherman, may I interest you in a tasty sherbet push-up? Or I've got lemon ice cream, green tea ice cream, butterscotch ice cream, chocolate ice cream.
I got tutti frutti ice cream, rocky road ice cream, vanilla ice cream. Maybe not, huh? By the way, what are you guys doing out here?
Don't you know this is a frozen lake?
Good question.
Thank you. to get out there and deliver the mail. I know it's 40 below and 3 feet of snowfall every hour, but remember.
I can't hear you.
But Captain, it's cold out there.
Cold? Small private. That's why you have these governmental issue clothes to wear.
It's all about being prepared, soldier. Being prepared! Now stand up, shoulders back, chest out, stomach in. You're the Chinese postal workers.
Ma'am! Now let me show you what I mean. Can I have a volunteer?
I just report it.
Oh, Miss
Mr. Walls, you've been snowing for days. When is it going to stop?
I don't know, kid, but I think I know exactly what the show needs right about now. A big snowstopper number.
A big green snowstopper? What a great idea.
But I love